a black magic woman. I got a black magic woman. Yes, I got a black magic woman. Got me so blind I can't see. That she's a black magic woman and she's trying to make a devil out of me.
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, beasts. Anybody else that's listening to this podcast? It's David.
It's Philip Bruce.
I have coffee yet again.
Red Bull for me.
Bitch, you're not meant to advertise the product.
Oh fuck. Like I said, bedroll. Real good shit.
Purple cow. My god.
Purple cow.
Phil, what we're talking about tonight?
We're talking about beauty.
We're talking about the perception of beauty.
Beauty is it's actually quite a deep philosophical concept, to tell you the truth.
It's a very deep philosophical concept. A lot more of a deeper concept and idea than we first thought.
Yeah.
Certainly for me.
Extremely. It's going to be an interesting one. We're going to delve real deep.
I want to start off like this. Phil.
Yeah.
Tell me what you think is beautiful. What, in your opinion, is beauty?
Like, in general or specifically on a female?
In general.
In general, it's anything that makes you, like, feel good. Do you want, like, an example?
Yeah, something that makes your heart sink. makes you feel gooey inside.
Well, the standard shit, landscapes, just beautiful, open landscapes, lots of colour.
Are you turned on by a heavy, sexy sunset like me?
Oh, fuck yeah.
I love a sexy sunset. Or a sunrise. Actually, anything to do with the sun.
Solar flare.
Oh, solar shit. Flare. Oh, God. Fuck talking about space already.
Yeah, the sun's absolutely amazing.
The sun is amazing.
It's just beautiful. Have you ever stared at it just to totally go off on a tangent? You ever, like, actually actively try to stare at the sun?
It doesn't. No, it's weird. It's not nice.
Fucking knocks. It's weird.
It really, really wrecks your eyes.
Yeah, it's, that's not.
Kids, if you're listening, or if there's any morons listening, like me and Phil, don't stare at the sun.
Yeah, well, I've already done that experiment for you. It doesn't work. It always ends in tears.
Things I think are beautiful. What's your idea of beauty in a woman?
Beauty in a woman?
Yeah. Without sounding sexist.
Without sounding like a fucking creep. Yeah. Well, it's totally subjective, isn't it? But we'll get into that. But for me personally, beauty in a woman, textbook shit, long, healthy hair,
mm-hmm.
Love long hair. Not like too tall, not offend any tall women out there. I'm a relatively short guy, so don't be offended. Nice full breasts.
Wow, he like, went there.
Nice and high up on the list of what I find attractive in a female. Like a nice round ass as well.
Mm.
But legs, specifically like tanned legs.
Yeah.
Love like tanned athletic legs.
I've never really been a leg man. Really?
I'm proper into them, mate.
Are you?
Yeah.
You've always been into legs.
Yeah. In fact, I was thinking about this earlier on. I have a memory of when I was like about 3 years old.
Steady now.
Yeah, this is this is fucked up shit. Nah. My next door neighbour, I remember like distinctly her standing there in her doorway. Excuse me, at the back door rather. And she was standing there in shorts. It was like summer and she had these like long, tanned, slim legs. Like I said, I was only about 3 or 4, and I just like had this overwhelming urge to just go up and touch these legs. So I did. So I just like walked over to her and just started like tickling up and down her legs. It was fucking weird. Now I look at like fucking hell. And she was like, "Oh, are you tickling me legs?" And I was like, "Yeah, that's what I'm doing." But that was a sexual element to it. Even when I was that young, I was like,
"Wow."
I was like, "Yes, I want to touch her legs, yeah." And that must have like imprinted itself on my brain because I've always been into legs ever since then.
Wow.
Freak.
That is.
Yeah.
Early developer.
Yeah. I suppose. In fact, just to chip in again with if we fast forward about 2 or 3, about 2 years when I was in like reception, and there was this girl sitting there in like, you know, like assembly or something like that. And she was wearing a skirt and I looked at her leg. And again, this is what I'm like 4 or 5 years old, yeah? And I put my hand on her leg and I went, "Oh, sorry, I thought that was my leg." I didn't use like a fucking American accent. And she was like just like laughing and stuff. And I was thinking, I got away with that. Fucking weirdo, man. So I've always had a thing for legs.
We're sat very close.
It's weird, isn't it?
I'm
almost touching David's leg right now. I might touch it.
Not quite, not yet. Do you want to know what I think is beautiful?
Yes.
Hmm. Probably the same as you. Landscapes.
Mm-hmm.
Sexual landscapes. With the right lighting.
Yeah.
You can just make even the biggest shithole look amazing.
Yeah, that's true. I find that about like British cities. They look absolutely shit.
In grey, murky days.
Yeah, like just, they all look the same. They all look really shit. But yeah. Then when it's sunny, it's like, oh, what a great country this is. Beautiful place.
The sun just brings everything to life, doesn't it?
It totally does.
Everything just comes to life. Having said that, though, I do like misty, murky, rainy days.
Aye.
In particular, if I'm, say, out in the countryside, up in the hills or something like that, where there's a vibe.
Yeah.
That's, I love that. Being out in the wild and it's just, the weather's just, and the elements take over and it's...
Yeah. Oh, there's nothing more beautiful than a proper storm as well, like...
Oh, yeah.
I want to just start off...
Thunder, lightning. It's amazing. Yeah, we haven't had a good storm around here for a while, have we? In the northeast.
No, not a proper one.
No,
there was one the other week, wasn't there? A bit of thunder and lightning.
Oh, not a...
It wasn't an absolute tank of a storm.
No. That's what I want, a tank of a storm.
Yeah, I want a fucking apocalyptic, it's all ending type of storm.
The sky's on fire sort of static air. Anyway, let's get back on subject. We're talking about beauty. Tell me your thoughts on human physical attractiveness.
Human physical attractiveness. Well, you've got to question why are certain things beautiful? So, for example, it's like a universal that men will find, like across cultures, men will find like generally larger, firm breasts attractive.
Yeah.
They'll find long hair typically pretty attractive. Fairly small nose and chin. Basically things that are like markers of youth and health and ultimately fertility, because I think that's like from a male perspective, beauty is generally markers that represent fertility. So it's, you're looking for the bitches that are going to be able to get pregnant immediately.
Yeah.
You know?
So we're talking curvy women.
Curvy women, yeah.
Mm, Kelly Brookstyle.
Oh,
Kelly, if you want to come on the podcast, we're more than happy to accommodate you.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
Fuck, you can even stay over.
Yeah, she gets Googled quite often.
Once Phil, how fucking dare you? That's a woman.
I'm sorry. How dare I?
So,
but then, in terms of women looking at men, that's probably more interesting, because it's pretty obvious the men desiring females and what they find desirable. But on the flip side of the coin, what women find attractive in men is also like really interesting, in that they, you know, the standard things: broad shoulders, big chest, big back, big arms, just big shit, you know what I mean?
But also
like a lot of like non-physical things as well, like mainly, like above all, confidence.
Mm.
Like I think that's like the number one like desire trait in a male.
The ability to make a woman laugh.
Humour, yeah, humour's like right up there with confidence, without a doubt.
Pretty amazing, really. But women, I've heard, don't like men that are too big in general.
What, like physically?
For example,
too big?
Like the bodybuilders. A lot of women don't like a man that's huge.
Yeah.
I mean, big.
To like the point where it's just
jacked. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, most probably don't.
I mean, there's always individuals out there that like they like.
If you think, though, that's unnatural, lad, to actually get, like, it's classed to men, isn't it? Like, every man wants to be a fucking absolute jacked beast. But that's actually unnatural. The human body's only ever going to, like, grow up a certain size muscle mass-wise, isn't it?
Naturally, without the aid of steroids.
Exactly, and so these dudes who are jacked up on steroids, which I've got absolutely no problem with people taking steroids, it's fucking class. but that's, like, what the women are probably picking up on there is that, that's not natural. So does that, in a sense, suggest bad genes? Like, you know, like, on a subconscious level, is that what they're, like, assuming?
Yeah.
Because it is unnatural. Is that why they... I don't actually think it's that, because it looks fucking amazing. So I think it's probably more a case of they're looking at that guy thinking he gives more of a shit about how he looks than like anything else. You know, like these weird fucking Geordie Shore type freaks.
Ugh, let's not give a shout out to the people at Geordie Shore. We went to a, you know, obviously I was at my girlfriend's graduation the other week, and they just finished filming when we were there.
Aye.
And I walked past one of them, and I didn't even realise it was her. It was one of them off Geordie Shore. I wouldn't look twice. I'd probably walk past them in the street and not realise it was them. I just don't see the attraction and the appeal to people like that.
I don't find them attractive in any sense physically, and personality-wise, they just have the shittest personalities ever.
All they want to do is go out and party and just make an absolute prat of themselves. It's fair enough people want to go out and have a good time, but for them, in a way, it's all about image.
Oh, totally, yeah.
And I don't want to, you know, I don't want to sound like I'm discrediting them.
I do.
But those guys are fucking assholes.
Pieces of fucking shit.
You piece of fucking shit, you come to the garage and I'll fuck you up. No, I won't, that's someone.
Come to the car. Very violent tonight.
I know, I've got it's because I've got this coffee, you see, Phil.
Oh, shit. What
one? Wait, it's just really strong.
Two scoops or three?
I've got definitely two heaped. And bear, I'm trying to wean myself off milk when I'm having coffee. So it's nigh on, but I don't know.
Like
I'm just trying to do it. No, because I can't do that. It's not to do with healthiness, because there's two heaped fucking sugars in there. So, mean, there's nothing good for us in this coffee.
Yeah.
But I just thought, I'm going to try and go black. But I'm going to slowly get there. I'm going to inch it in by taking less milk each time. See if I go black and then don't go back. Because that's like apparently how you meant to have the coffee, isn't it? The best way to have coffee is black.
Yeah, and with shitloads of butter in it as well.
Yes.
Grass-fed butter.
Do you just mix it in?
Yeah, you just mix it in. Like, obviously there's... It's better to do... what are them fucking mixing tools called? You know, like a spinny fucking thing?
Oh, like...
I've got one.
I can't even remember what they're called.
Yeah. It's better to use one of them as opposed to just fucking putting a slab of butter in and just stirring it with your fucking teaspoon.
Why is butter good in coffee?
Because the fat. Like, not just like any old butter. Like, any old butter.
Yeah. I'm going to put some Lurpak inside of my...
Yeah, that's not the best, but specifically grass-fed butter, because of all the healthy fats that's in it. It's meant to it's meant to give you energy throughout the day. Like, it's just going to... It's meant to be amazing.
I'll have to try it sometime.
Yeah. A good luck finding unsalted grass-fed butter, however, in England. I haven't fucking found it, motherfuckers.
So, going back off coffee and talking back about beauty.
Yeah.
Can you tell me about beauty in art?
Beauty in art?
Like, if
that's a very good question. That's a very good concept, because as with like beauty in general, specifically when you're talking about art, it's a subjective experience, isn't it? So like, what one person may find beautiful,
some
another may find to be an absolute piece of shit.
It's very similar to music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And like physical attractiveness. Like some people are like, yeah, I don't find that attractive at all. Like the bodybuilder type thing.
Yeah. And
whereas
some
other
people
girls are like, I fucking love those big jacked freaks. You know. So. But
we're not. You're not freaks. We love you, beautiful creatures. Keep lifting.
Oh, fucking! I would love to fucking be absolutely jacked like that. What 5% body fat and like all that muscle mass? Every lad wants to look like that.
Walking around in a thong and that.
with those fucking T-Rex arms.
T-Rex arms, a little pecker. Yeah. So we're saying about art and music.
Yeah.
And how it affects different people in different ways, and what one person sees as beautiful and amazing, somebody else might be the total opposite and think, wow, that's just not what I'm into whatsoever.
It's probably like to do with your development, like your emotional state, what resonates with you, isn't it?
Yeah.
So if you, for example, if you feel like particularly down and you hear like some sad music, that's going to appear a lot more beautiful to you at that time than if you're like feeling really upbeat and then you hear it.
Sad music, we're talking Sinead O'Connor, we're talking Dido.
Dido. What was I like to call her?
Dildo. Phil, that's not her name.
I'm sorry.
How dare you? In terms of the love of the beauty within music, I can't stand the music, and I use the word lightly because it's not music to me, of One Direction. You compare that to something like Led Zeppelin and their guitar riffs, and I just listen to a certain song and you just turn it right up when you've got your earphones in and you just pick out different pieces of ear candy in the mix, and it's just, I thrive off music. Music's one of my main passions. I love music.
Yeah.
And that is, to me, in a way, a form of beauty. A good song that I like.
Without a doubt. I'd like to take the extreme, me though. Like, as soon as I find a song that I like, and there's loads of people like this. This is typical of like an addict though. As soon as I find a song that I like, it's just on repeat until
That's me. Just replay. Yeah. Rewind
like
bits. And
like, sometimes I'm like, can the neighbours hear this? And can they hear that I'm like playing it again and again and again for like hours on end? And if so, are they like a bit worried that I might be a friggin' maniac? You know?
I'm totally the same.
Who the fuck knows?
It's like when I get new clothes, I'll generally wear them to death before I buy anything new.
Oh, yeah.
But is there any art you like in particular? Are you an art fan?
What, like paintings?
Any type of art, paintings, whether it's, you know, modern art or the work of Picasso.
There's a guy what's he called? I've just got a book on him as well. I think it might be John Milton. I might have got that wrong. But basically, he's this guy. He was from like the northeast, like say 1800s or something, and he like would paint these images, like these huge fucking images. Paints, not fucking.
It's not a computer. Kind of JPEG.
Yeah, these massive JPEGs with a paintbrush. No, he would paint like these huge landscapes. You would actually probably like really appreciate some of his stuff.
Yeah.
These massive like landscapes, just like really awe inspiring. But like a lot of them have to do, like a lot of these paintings have to do with like hell and like biblical like themes and stuff like that. And, like, as we can. As we probably know by now, I'm not a Christian at all. Yeah. But I like those like stories, like the idea of like of demons and stuff like that.
That's perfect, because what I love is I love the sort of old-fashioned 16th, sort of 15th, 16th, 17th style century artwork of like demons and devils and things and witchcraft. Yeah. And it's just, it's artwork, but it's done, it's all like black, just black lines.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not like it's coloured in or painted. And that was just the way of like, publicising things at the time, if they had like posters up or newspapers, etc., etc. Yeah. Just the idea of the demons and things that are drawn on that with their tongues coming out. And it's just, it's so prehistoric the way it looks, but it's done in such a way that it's quite artistic. Good, because I've tried to replicate it myself, just doodling.
Can you draw? Can you? Can you draw like?
What? I can draw, right? Yeah, I'm trying to get back into it, but
God, I have no ability to draw at all. It's depressing.
But a few years ago, I just tried to doodle as like a demon in that style.
Yeah.
Because their demons look kind of like wolves back then. They were kind of like wolves. They were kind of strange. And I just failed miserably. And there is like a little bit of an art to it.
That's interesting that there'd be wolves. Because that's probably like, back then was probably one of their like main legit fucking skits as well, wasn't it? Like, oh shit, be careful going in the woods because there's legitimately wolves here.
Mm-hmm. You know, I said 16th century. I think it might have been earlier.
Just googling here. We're just googling images.
I'm trying to find an image that corroborates what I'm saying. We'll keep talking while I find it. So,
oh, yeah.
Beauty. Beauty in acts of love and kindness.
Yes. Yeah, so like,
somebody helping a homeless man.
Yeah, like, so beauty's not always like a physical thing, is it?
No.
Like a painting or a piece of music or someone's titties. You know, it can actually be an act. You know, like, oh, it was beautiful the way he fucking fingered my butthole or something. You know? Ah, nice pick. The freak you on there.
Yeah, so this is just...
Is that meant to be the devil?
Well, just like a demon. This is like medieval artwork, which I'll put a link to this down below in the description box so that you're not just listening to us looking at this. You know, actually, you'll be able to see it.
Yeah.
But, acts of beauty in terms of acts of kindness.
Uh-huh.
What do you think about that? Do you think that's just...
Well, it's like... it's like... Beauty, like, is desire, isn't it? So, what we desire a lot of times is going to be something that's good for us. Something that's healthy. So, to see, like, an act of kindness, well, that's good for us. It's good for you individually. It's good for the fucking tribe, traditionally.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, that would make sense why we would describe... act of kindness and love is beautiful, because that's what's desired. Like, that behaviour is desirable.
So that sort of behaviour isn't selfless.
Mm-hmm.
You think that sort of behaviour is done with intent, because it's always going to look good on that person who's doing that act of kindness.
So it isn't selfless, is it?
It's not a selfless act. Like, it's always going to make that person look better who does the act.
Yeah, that's a huge philosophical question in itself, though. The whole, is there such a thing as a selfless act, though?
Yeah.
Because I would suggest, no.
Do you think that people's perceptions of beauty is kind of sculpted from their upbringing?
Well,
or do you think it's something that's born, that the person's born with?
Well, fucking hell, if I can stop coughing for a second.
Don't die, Phil, come on.
I'll try not to. Well, it's going to be like both, isn't it? You've got your genetic programming,
mm-hmm.
like, and you can prove this by studying people from across the world, seeing what like universal things are found to be attractive
yeah.
in people. Like I think I said earlier, you know, like long hair, that kind of shit is
yeah.
generally desirable across all cultures. So there's certain things that are just there programmed into you, and then there's also, without a doubt, going to be like cultural, like condition in terms of what you find beautiful, like, you know, with fashion, specifically fashion.
Yes, fashions.
Because there's a lot of like, fucking like, you know, if you look at the '80s stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like I look at a lot of those chicks then, and I'm like, she looks fucking stupid. But it's like, oh, but she, you know, oh, everyone fancied her back then. And
crazy, isn't it? How, you know? How things change. Big shoulder pads and things.
Yeah.
What's she got that on for?
Yeah, shoulder pads in particular. What a fucking weird idea that would be sexy. Because
to make a woman,
the last thing I want is a woman to be have like broad shoulders.
Strange, isn't it?
So how the fuck was that like something that was like, oh yeah, that'll attract men.
I just hope it doesn't come back.
Oh, it can't come back. If it does, I'm out here.
It's pretty women and beautiful women back then were made it look so much more masculine by having these huge giant shoulder pads, which did nothing for them.
Yeah.
But it's just trends of the time, isn't it? I mean, everything comes back.
Mm-hmm.
Like 90s trends are coming back, and you see haircuts these days that resemble 1950s style haircuts.
Yeah.
Everything just comes back.
I'm quite disappointed in that specific example there, because when I was a kid, I always looked at those 1950s haircuts and thought, that looks fucking mint, that like really short, like, you know, the Hitler fucking haircut essentially. And I was like, oh, I want to do that. And I used to like experiment with that when I was a kid and that. And then here it is now, and it's totally like massive. Everyone's got a haircut. It looks mint as well, but I kind of pull it off now because the fucking receding hairline. So that ship is sealed.
Yeah, but you're a manly man, so you get away with it.
Yeah. Just shaving that motherfucker.
What does beauty mean to you, Phil?
What does it mean to me?
Yeah.
Beauty to me is more distressing than anything else.
Yeah.
Because it's one of those things where it's like, oh, I'm not like in any way materialistic or anything like that. But, you know, a bit of jealousy does like come into play from time to time. It's not like, oh, I want to look like that guy, but sometimes it's like, oh, that looks class. That would be mint if I looked like that. Or, oh, that Ferrari's absolutely amazing. Wouldn't it be class to just bomb around in that?
Yeah.
Or, fucking hell, she's absolutely lush. I wish I was whatever. You know what I mean? So, beauty to me, to an ugly person,
how dare you, Phil?
It can be like frustrating, but that's pretty deep psychological shit. That
yeah.
But generally beauty to me, enjoyment. You know,
having a good time.
Like that's what it's all about, isn't it? Desire. Like that's beautiful. Therefore, it is something that I want.
Mm.
Generally beauty isn't something that you don't want. Like, oh yeah, she's beautiful, but I don't want to shag her. You don't have any of that. Like, you know? Obviously, that like maybe it's a shit example, but...
No, I know what you're saying, Are you surprised that in these past few years that have been hit by a recession since 2008, was it? 2007, maybe?
Yeah.
Since the UK went into a recession. Double dip, treble dip, quadruple dip, whatever we keep dipping into, but we're still in the recession now, apparently, and... Do you not think it's amazing that the beauty industry hasn't been affected by that? If anything, its sales are up.
Yeah, that is a fascinating fact.
Even though in these times of hardship, where there's not many jobs and people are struggling, people are still willing to pay a lot of money to look beautiful.
Because what does that suggest? That suggests that...
Everything's about image to me.
Image and...
Status.
Exactly. And at its base level, people... still want to fuck them, no matter how much money they've lost or you know, or what the social standing is or this or that, and the fact is people still want to fuck, and maybe if, like, this is just pure conjecture here, but maybe it's a reason why the beauty industry has actually like increased its like profitability could be because people are like subconsciously getting like a little bit worried that oh fuck, men aren't able to provide as much as what they necessarily have. Like, there's not as many men able to provide to such a like high degree as what they used to be able to. So I'm gonna have to make myself look extra sexy to compete with the other females to get the guy that can give me what I want. You know, the status, the material shit.
Just
a PR theory.
It just amazes me that even, you know, in a time when a lot of people haven't got money, people are still willing to pay the high costs and high,
but it makes you feel good, doesn't it? Like, everybody feels good when they feel that they look good.
Yeah. Everything is image based, I feel, these days. You see, you get it rammed down your throat with TV shows, glamorous TV shows,
yeah,
the likes of Mad Men and things like that, where everything's glamorous. And then you've got magazines, TV, yeah, fashion articles, fashion sections on TV shows that tell you how to look,
yeah,
programs about fashion, movie posters, movie stars looking amazing when they're all dolled up with X amount of cash and
yeah,
beauticians who sort them out and things. It's rammed down your throat. It's a lot like reality TV is a big thing at the minute. Everything's reality based, and that's just getting slung out one after the other. All these different shitty programs, and all these people are looking good, and it's reality, and people just want to be like them. So everybody wants to look prettier, and everybody wants to look better. I think the media has a massive control over the population in terms of people wanting to look beautiful.
Unquestionably, just you know, it's cliche to like talk about these kind of things. The thing I'm about to bring up, but the, you know, the whole magazine, like women's fucking magazines, where it's pretty much all about picking apart the way other women look. Like, how, look at this traditionally glamorous woman. Look how absolutely shite she actually looks. So it's all like they're trying to like put forward this idea. Well, I don't know if they're trying to do this, but this is what it appears to be, that like, oh, you should look glamorous all the time, no matter what the scenario, like, and that's obviously totally unrealistic.
Mm-hmm.
And but they're putting such an like an emphasis, like such an importance, yeah, on how you look. Like, you know, I doubt most people are reading these magazines and getting their life philosophy from them, thinking, oh fucking hell, this is how I'm meant to live life and all this kind of thing. But on some level, it's gonna affect you, isn't it? You know, like not me, but women. It's gonna affect them. Because it's there in the culture, in the background anyway, so that's been absorbed by your brain.
It could be anyway. Subliminal.
Yeah.
Subliminally, women want to, and men, it's not just women, we're not being sexist. Women and men do want to look great as well. I mean, these days, that's probably happened for years and years, but men shave their chests and they're going more towards the preen. Men have always preened.
Yeah.
The past 30, 40 years, whatever, maybe more, men have always preened, but at the minute, there's so much like emphasis on a man being ripped, and there's so much emphasis because of the media again. A man being ripped, a man having no hairs on his chest, looking perfect all the time.
Effectively adopting feminine traits,
basically,
which is really fucking weird to me. I don't understand. This is where women have let us down by fucking falling for that bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why is that? I really can't get my head around this. Like, how is that attractive to a female? Like, like. We desire the opposite, you know, unless you're like gay, then you don't. Like, you desire the same. But, you know, like generally, men desire women because they're different to us, like totally fucking different. Like,
yeah,
it's like, oh, look at the curves, look at the, you know, the shapes, the, this, that. And women, vice versa, traditionally fancy men because of the, you know, that they embody completely different characteristics to what they have. So, how on earth have we ended up at a point now where men adopting, like, or shedding their, like, masculinity and adopting these female, like, not characteristics, but, like,
traits and,
like, like physical traits, mm-hmm, like, fucking the eyebrows thing and the tan and all that bullshit.
That's crazy. Men that tan, I mean, it's just, it's
fucking weird. But, like, how the fuck have women ended up desiring that? Well, I suppose then you could,
I think
say,
it's the media.
You could say it's the same as the 80s, isn't it? What I was saying about the shoulder pads. How did men desire women that look like that then?
Mm-hmm.
How do fucking guys feel okay doing that?
What, shaving their chest, waxing,
like,
it,
like the fucking, like all that. Like, I can understand that if you're ripped and you want to, like, you want to show off your,
fair enough, yeah,
like your cuts and all that kind of shit. I can understand that. Fair enough. But the eyebrows thing,
and the fake tan, men fake tan, men going on sunbeds.
Yeah, like, and shaving your fucking arse and all that kind of shit.
Hello, honey.
Unless you're just shaving your arse just for shits and gigs, but like, I shave my pubes actually. Well, that's
I shave my sack.
Yeah, you've got to, haven't you?
You've got to.
Makes certain things easier.
Dirty boy.
But,
it worries me because I'm quite a hairy man, as are you.
Yeah.
We've got hairy chests and that, and you know, we get thick beard growth and hairy backs, whatever. We're not fucking, but I'm describing when I pick up the Bigfoots here.
Or a couple of bears, like gay bears, like rare. Relatively big guys with there, a lot of hair on our chests and asses.
Oh my god!
Something for a couple of twinks.
But I mean, I don't understand it. It just doesn't make sense.
It's crazy, isn't it?
I'm gonna wax my chest, and I'm going to go out wearing an incredibly low-cut vest to try and pull some ladies.
Yeah, what's disappointing, though, is...
The girls fall for it.
That, yeah, at the end of the night,
he got it.
He fucking did, actually, get to pull that lush-looking lass. Mm. It sometimes makes me want to just kick off and just, like, turn up and just start whacking people. Like, no, like, not whacking them off. Like, just absolutely brilliant. Like, you know, this is bullshit, man. This is not how it's supposed to be.
So, do you think that's a way of getting your alpha status up there by using superiority in the form of beauty? If you can become the best looking person in your area, well, try to be, whether it's by hitting the gym and waxing your chest and getting your chest out all the time. Or
yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't know how the fuck it does resemble, like, alpha maleness, but, like, these days it somehow does. Maybe it's because it's, I blatantly don't give a shit about looking like a bell end. So maybe it's that. Piaz initially has confidence to women, so... Oh, this guy's confident.
But there is women out there who will always prefer the real more manly man.
Yes, thank fuck for that, otherwise I'd be fucked.
What I've seen, and it's only my opinion, so, you know, it doesn't hold any water, but... It's generally those sort of teenage girls, late teenage girls, that like that sort of guy that looks like a model with a shaven chest.
Yeah. Yeah.
From what I've seen, like, through Facebook. Not that I've got teenage girls on Facebook. My God. I'm just saying.
No. It's funny that you mentioned that, because I read something yesterday where it said at age, like, 20,
mm-hmm.
all of a sudden, you know, like, generally speaking here, all of a sudden women's tastes changes in terms of, like, what kind of males are attracted to. They go from fancying the little poncy model looking types, smooth skin and all this kind of shit, to actually being into or being attracted by, like, masculine men. So age 20, that's interesting. Also, a bit of a shame, because age 21 is definitely the absolute peak for women's attractiveness to men. It declines from there.
Is that true, is it?
Well, I would suggest that the women are at the ultimate, like, physical... The most physical attractiveness at a very young age.
Wow.
Without a doubt. And that declines from 21 onwards.
That's funny, you know, because I do like the look of some older women.
Oh, so do I, definitely.
But you think in terms of generalities, terms of a woman's, obviously, that peak attractiveness, there's that cut off point and then it just sort of mellows off.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would be inclined to agree with that.
And then, excuse me, it suggests that men hit their peak in terms of their dating pool, like market share type thing. Like the mm-hmm. most amount of people that's going to be into them is when they hit like age, you know, like around 30 to mid 30s.
Really?
Obviously they kind of pull the teens off Facebook anymore. Well, but they can pull. They can pull anyone they want. No, but they have, you know, they have women in their early 20s, right up to, like, you know, 30s, 40s, 50s. Yeah. So that's probably when men are seen at their, like, absolute peak masculinity. Even though, like, all the men are more manly as fuck, aren't they? But, like, you know, in terms of, right, well, you're almost in your physical peak, I guess, when you're in your 30s, if you've been fucking working out. and, you know, you're old enough to be confident. So... I don't know, it's an interesting one. It's kind of weird.
It's incredibly weird.
It's weird how they don't just, like, parallel each other.
No.
Like,
but different sexes, and if you look at the animal kingdom's totally a different setup to the way we do things. I mean, you've got the apes and you've got the alpha males and the gorillas that don't need the big nuts because they've got the power and they get the women.
Yeah.
Like the female gorillas. But then you look at things like birds that put on displays. And they all pretty much look uniform. Like, there's like humans. We all pretty much look different, don't we? We've all got like an individual face. But in terms of birds, for example, their look is very uniform.
Right,
they're almost kind of like clones.
That's interesting. I was having this conversation today, actually.
All right.
But about dogs.
Yeah.
And this person I was talking.
Dogs are the only other species, aren't they, that has got that diversity?
Well, that's what I was wondering. Like. Do birds not have that? Is it not just to us that all look exactly the same? But, like, do birds not recognise that, like, oh, yeah, that bird looks totally different to that bird and that bird? You know, like, how Chinese people, to, like, white people, this is politically incorrect, but I don't give a fuck, it's a fact. Like, they generally look really similar to, like, you know, Geordie people. Like, look at Chinese, like, you know, like, oh, they really look similar. But to Chinese people, they don't at all. Like, they all look totally different in the same way.
Yeah.
Us sitting here in Tynemouth, everyone looks different. So the birds, is it not the same for them, where they, like, can pick out, like, slight differences in
could
each other?
Could be. It could be. I mean, as a bird watcher, nine out of ten species look incredibly similar, and differences might be very, very slight, but then differences that are very slightly worse, they may be
absolutely huge.
They might be huge to the females and the males, and they might see things. They might see them slightly different. Maybe they look at them with a different eye in terms of the way the feathers are.
Yeah, I would imagine that the
it could be. It could totally be the way. Because I mean, we don't know much at all really about animal behaviour. Mm-hmm. Not like we know about ourselves, because we are humans, so we can study ourselves and.
Yeah. But you can't, like, you can't put yourself in the shoes of a bird and feel what it's like to be a bird.
No. Be fucking amazing.
Yeah. Oh, it would be absolutely phenomenal, wouldn't it?
Be a bird for a day. Just hope you don't get jacked by a sparrowhawk or something.
How do they shag? Birds? Do they, like...
They're just, like, I think they're just... They press... I don't want to start spouting bullshit, but they kind of just, like, touch. I think the male puts, like, a sperm packet on the female.
I like it.
I'm not 100%.
Hey, baby. Whoop, you're pregnant. See you later.
I'm just checking on Google.
How do birds reproduce?
It's a really quick thing. Apart from the ducks that were mentioned with the corkscrew dick.
Yeah.
Birds reproduce using internal fertilization. Most birds do not have a penis. Ostriches and ducks are a couple that do. Ooh, I didn't know ostriches had a penis.
Mm-hmm.
And made simply by pressing their cloacas. Ah, very similar to reptiles. I've got a leopard gecko and he's got a cloaca.
Uh-huh.
Which is just kind of like a... It's just like a fleshy pad, really. And they're made by simply pressing their cloacas together in what is known as a cloacal kiss. Damn.
That's cute, though, isn't it?
Generally, the male climbs onto the female's back to perform this act. Though some birds mate in flight, the male sperm is squirted into the female where it swims up her oviduct to her eggs, fertilising them. So it's a very quick thing. It's not like humans where it's a case of... We've got to keep repeating the same motion, in and out, in and out.
Yeah. They just attack you, fuck you. Bitch, you just be fucked.
Yuck. Bitch, you're fertilised. It's amazing, isn't it? It's like fish. When the female fish lays the eggs, and then the male just fires out his love venom over the top of the...
It's classic.
It's crazy that to think about how there's so many different ways that creatures on this planet reproduce.
Yeah.
Like snails. Have you seen snails? Where they just like sort of intertwine. It's the craziest thing. I'm just going to type in snail mating.
Snail porn.
Snail porn. Snail tube. These pictures aren't very good. There you go. It's like a torpedo thing that comes out of the male.
What? Where the fuck's that coming out of? Like his fucking shoulder or something? I can't really make that up.
It's near his head. It comes out and it just sort of sticks in it. It's like a little...
Hence the phrase dickhead.
Dickhead? It's like a tone... It looks like a torpedo because it's got
a
spiked tip.
Mad. Oh, he just jabs it with it. He's a little rapist bastard.
It's mad, isn't it? It's amazing.
That is some crazy shit.
It is crazy. Maybe it's earthworms that do something funny, I'm not sure. Or do they breed asexually? I can't remember.
Earthworm.
Yeah, look at that.
Whoa.
They just kind
of... What the fuck's that long shit in the middle? Or is that just like the end of each tail?
Whereabouts?
Tail. Could you see the earth?
Genital paws and they just stick against each other. That's mad.
I didn't realize it was paws P-O-R-E. I thought it was just like P-A-U-S-E. Where they're just like paws.
Paws.
Yeah, just lie here for a fucking couple of hours and see what happens.
Damn.
2 hours later, I got a boner. Let's do it.
So do you think
we've covered
quite a bit on beauty today, tonight?
Yeah.
There's obviously more we can go into. I'd like to get my better half on in the future, and she can probably bring a much better input to the conversation because of the fact that she works for one of the biggest beauty consultant sort of companies in this country. So she's worked in the industry and she knows how.
So what do they do? Like, who do they consult per se? Do you know what I mean? Like, what is the job of, like, a beauty consultancy?
Well, her job is kind of just selling the products, really.
Right.
really. I can't obviously say the name of the company, but she's because of her experience of working through the company and doing meetings and things like that, she knows how it works. And for example, she knows how the recession hasn't affected the beauty industry, whereas it's affected everything else.
Yeah,
but it's not affected the beauty industry, and not just not affected it. Like we were saying earlier, it's on the up, which is just it's just insane.
It's very very fucking interesting shit that like.
And she knows more about
evolutionary theory would probably help.
Yeah, I think so.
I'll tell you what's an interesting topic. But I haven't got much interesting to say about it. like sexual selection, like the theory of like sexual selection, which is pretty much what I've like been talking about.
In terms of going for somebody who's got the broad back and
Like,
the curvy body
and so like how these traits are desirable, and these people are more likely to get like a mate to fuck. But my question is, if there's been thousands of years of sexual selection, which there probably has,
it'd be more than
like. My question is, why are there still ugly people?
Wow, he went there, folks.
Like you know what I mean?
Because
like, how come every? I know like nutrition plays a massive part in like height and things like this.
I'm gonna go out on a limb with this one.
Oh yeah.
And I'm gonna say the reason there's still ugly people. And I don't like saying that because
it sounds nasty.
It sounds nasty, but the reason there's still ugly people. Is because
ugly people fuck ugly people.
Ugly people fuck ugly people, and it's like a circle. It's like it's because
they have to fuck still, so they're just gonna a three's gonna go, bitch. You're a three, so let's recognize that I'm what you're gonna get here. So let's you gotta have to fuck me, bitch, because you ain't getting that seven over
there. It's kind of this sounds dodgy saying this, but it's a class thing.
Yeah, like a sexual class.
It's a sexual class system. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to get a supermodel that's fucking somebody that goes on Jeremy Kyle with virtually no teeth.
Yeah.
But that person that's got virtually no teeth that's on Jeremy Kyle will fuck somebody else that lives in the same council estate as they do.
Yeah.
And looks as dodgy as they do. It's just, there's different classes.
But, like, say earlier on,
I suppose...
It still doesn't make sense.
Well, I suppose in a way they're opportunists. They'll kind of take what they can get. And this sounds really pretentious saying this about ugly people. But... they'll kind of take what they can get, and it's like
it's not just men. I'm like on a
hey, we're guys, you know. We drink coffee and drink beer, and we're just fucking assholes. Come fuck us.
Come fuck us right now. We're at a
don't fucking tell them.
I've got to tell where this address is. It's 5 Seaside Town.
We're on a fucking boat. You can't get us.
Fucking some mermaids.
That's a good idea for a future podcast. Mermaids.
I think it's a future porno.
That'd be good too.
Yeah.
Except the parts would be fishy, wouldn't it?
Oh, imagine the stink.
Stink. Imagine the slime too. And I suppose if she can only squirt out eggs, the fucking's going to be shit. You have to jack on her eggs, wouldn't you?
Just get like tit wanked all the time and then just beat off on the eggs.
Oh, what if she's got them oysters? Them shells covering her
fucking
nipples.
That's coming off straight away.
What if they're stuck on them? What's that? What if that's the nipples?
Oh, like barnacles.
Like barnacles? Barnacle nipples will cut your dick up.
Oh, it's still like
titty wank? No, bitch. No. Not today.
Yeah, it's still spray on them, to be fair. Take a photo of it. I gotta show the guys this.
This has gotta go on Instagram. Oh, we've got an Instagram, by the way. If anybody's listening and they're interested, we have a Twitter, we have a Facebook, and we have an Instagram now.
Oh, we're getting real big now. Just real fucking big.
Just go into search bars and type in 2 Guys, 1 Garage podcast, and it'll just... You'll find what.
Yeah.
You'll find what. Why do I keep speaking American?
I don't know, but it's
why do I keep speaking American? I'm from the northeast of England.
What was the other one we were doing before? Oh, yes, the Indian one that we...
talk like this.
We tried to talk a little
we're
bit.
We're going to get taken down of YouTube.
But hopefully not before the next couple of podcasts get released.
Any ideas about what's in store for the future podcast? Oh, we have some exciting things coming up with a collaboration with a friend of ours.
Yeah, that's going to be a beast of a podcast.
We'll not use surnames, but he shall go by the name of Ryan. And we're looking forward to doing a space-based podcast with him in the next couple of days.
Oh, it's going
to
get deep.
That one could be quite a long one, or it could be splitting a couple of parts. Yeah.
Either way, there's going to be tons of knowledge.
So much knowledge exchanged and so much learning because I need to learn more about space.
Anything about space in particular that like really draws
everything.
In? Yeah, it's all just
the entire concept of space, all of it.
Yeah,
blows my mind.
Black holes probably being the sexiest.
Black holes, yeah.
Of all space related phenomena.
Mm-hmm. There's white holes as well, isn't there?
Yeah. Shit that spews shit out.
Yeah.
Which crazy. Could be the black holes from like another universe.
Multiverses, different dimensions. Yeah. I'd quite like to do one about reptilians in the future.
Reptilians?
The reptilian theory.
Hit the old reptilians again.
Old reptilians. Well, we've done the Greys.
That was part one, wasn't it? The actual Illuminati.
Oh, you want about? I was just talking about
specifically
like we did for the Greys, but for reptilians.
So apes.
Which kind of it kind of incorporates the Illuminati, but this one purely on the theory of the reptilians being in control, and possibly being in control of other aliens and star systems, and them kind of being like the cunts of the galaxy.
It would make sense, since reptiles are absolute cold-blooded wankers.
They just don't give a fuck.
They really don't?
They don't.
Pieces of shit.
They've got no empathy. Zero empathy, they'll just...
That's horrible, isn't it?
It is horrible. I've got a leopard gecko, and I cannot really say that, because he's the cutest guy. But,
what is it? Gecko, what is it?
I've got a leopard gecko. Gizmo, he's called.
Gizmo.
It's a really original name for a pet. I've had him for about 10 years now.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
What are they like? Do they show any affection at all? These reptiles of yours. Do they lick you and shit, or is that just a taste?
That's just a sensory thing. But in terms of empathy, and
I suppose they're not going to fucking like cuddle up you like a cat on it.
Pet ones I've seen on YouTube that like getting tickled and things, but in terms of a wild one, no. You know what I mean? But
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying,
mate. Do you know what I'm saying,
mate? Like, about reptiles now, how they're just absolute arseholes.
They've just got
absolute tits, mate. But I had a Bible, because I thought I was going to change them. I was going to change the way they behave.
So have you got any ideas for future...
Future podcasts?
Podcasts that you want to talk about? If anybody is interested in the idea of future podcasts, get in touch with us and we'll think about your ideas and maybe talk about them.
Yeah, we'll shoot them down.
We'll give you a shout out.
Yeah, no, one that I'm really looking forward to doing, but... probably won't be for a while because I want to do tons more research as addiction.
Nice.
Since I have addiction. A shit ton of experience with being addicted.
Yes. And like my girlfriend says, I'm addicted to my phone and this podcast.
Yeah.
So
so there you
I'm
go.
I'm an asshole. No, I've definitely got an addictive personality and somewhat obsessive to a degree.
Aye.
I wouldn't say I was OCD, but I'm looking forward to doing that podcast. That'll be a good one.
That'll get real fucking deep.
You probably realised whilst you've been listening to these 8 podcasts that the subjects that we're talking about are kind of all over the place. You've got the conspiracy things, you've got the psychological kind of aspect to it, philosophical aspect.
Just life.
Just life, just different genres, different things.
We're just humans that are perceiving shit, and that's what life's all about, isn't it? How you perceive. What you perceive, how you perceive it, and what choices you make as a result. That's all life is, in a nutshell.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Data. Just receiving data. And figuring out what to do with it. That is literally all life is.
Yeah. It's crazy.
It's pretty depressing. It's not that deep, is it? It is once you start looking into it, but like,
yeah,
described in that way, it sounds pretty shit, yeah.
Especially when you start looking into the universe and the size and scale of that, and you compare that to us, and we're worth nothing. Our lives that we build up so much, and we put so much emphasis on the smallest of things. Yeah. That guy nicked my phone.
Yeah.
Well, fuck your phone, because in terms of the universe, that's worth nothing. That's nothing.
Yeah.
In the grand scheme of things.
It's mad, isn't it?
It's crazy.
It's mad how the size of things, like the physical size,
mm-hmm.
like impacts how much, like, I don't know what the word be, like importance we place on it. Like, it, for example, standing an ant, don't give as much of a shit about that as somebody shooting a fucking elephant. Yet they're both creatures. And when you start thinking about the universe, like in the grand... like the grand fucking scale of the universe, it's, that makes you think, oh, well, we're not that important because the universe is so big.
Yeah.
But there's probably like arguments you could put forward to really like shoot that idea down and say that, like, because really, fuck it. I'll save all this for possibly the space podcast or another one. Otherwise, we're just going to start up another fucking podcast.
I know. This was meant to be really based.
Yeah.
But no, we hope you've enjoyed this one tonight.
Yeah. It's been very sexy, very hot.
We hope we haven't offended any people, but hey.
Hey, like, shit happens, motherfucker.
We're just shooting the shit, being natural. That's what it's all about.
Always wear a condom.
Always wear a condom. Have fun. Don't wear a condom if you can get a face shot in. No, do wear a condom, just whip it off.
Oh, that'd be good if you want to spray someone in the face, you know, the condom on, and you're like, I'm going to do it, baby, I'm going to... Where is it?
I think that's happened to me before, yeah. Nightmare situation.
Allegedly.
Right. Okay, good night, folks. Enjoy your evening. Hope you've enjoyed this.
Good night, boys and girls.
Follow us on social networking sites. Type in Two Guys, One Garage. Like us on Facebook. Subscribe. And join the garage crew. Yo, yo.
Yo, the garage crew, motherfuckers.
Motherfucker. See you later. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Yes, don't turn your back on me, baby. You're messing up.